Good morning. I appreciate that you stayed for the last session. This talk is about ad hoc private simultaneous message protocol, secure computation without coordination with Yuval Ishai and Eyal Kushilevitz, and I'll explain the title in a few slides. So what is ad hoc MPC introduced by us and Ariel Gabinson? So the basic problem, we have a universe of n honest but curious parties. Out of these n parties, only k parties, a set S of k parties, not known in advance, will participate in the actual computation, secure computation of some function f. And for simplicity, we'll assume that f is symmetric. So what are the motivation for this? One is very relevant to what will happen in France in 2 days, is voting. There are many possible voters. Out of them, only some of them will vote. Another one is dating. There are many people, but only two of them will come and will want to see if they match. So again, there's a big universe and smaller number of parties that will participate. In the standard MPC model, this question is simple. The parties will communicate, will find out who the other parties, and then execute the simple, the usual MPC. But the question is, can we do that without adding coordination and without adding communication rounds? And we'll consider this question is the simplest possible communication model of private simultaneous message protocols introduced by Feger, Kilian, and Or, and Ishai and Kushilevitz. So this is, again, the simplest communication pattern possible. There are n parties, each one holds an input, and there's a referee. The goal of the referee is to compute some function of the input, and each party sends one message independent of the other messages of the other parties, and we'll have a correctness and security, for that we'll have need that the parties will have a shared randomness, so they'll have a shared random string. For efficiency reasons, we think about it as a correlated string where each party holds part of the shared string, but this is only efficiency, it's not a security requirement, so we can use only shared correlated randomness. And again, we have two requirements. We have the correctness. The referee should learn the output of the function, the correct output of the function, and the security says that the referee learns nothing besides the output of the function. So this is a PSM model. Let's speak about ad hoc PSM. So again, we have n parties, and they have the correlated randomness. But exactly k parties will show up. In this example, k is equal to, and p2 and pn will show up. And in this case, the goal of the referee is to compute f of x2 and xn. The participants are not known in advance. So for instance, instead of pn, it can be that p2 and p3 showed up. This shouldn't change the message of p2. And P3 will not know that P2 is the other party, so each party is not aware of the other party that will participate in this ad hoc PSM model. Let's speak about some assumptions and variants. In the basic model, we assume that exactly K parties will show up. If less than K parties show up, the referee should learn nothing. And if more than K parties show up, we don't guarantee any security. So this is the basic model. We also consider a model where we require security even when more than k parties show up. Notice that if more than k parties show up, even in the ideal world, the referee can compute the value of f of any subset of size k of the parties that send messages. So in the best possible security for sets of size bigger than k will require that the adversary, the referee learns these values of f and nothing else. So we again, we have the basic model and the best possible security model. In this talk, we'll assume that f is symmetric. The function does not depend on the identity of the parties that will show up and not on the order that they show up. We can also consider non-symmetric functions, but for this talk, we will only consider symmetric functions. The set S is not known to the parties, but we, in a basic model, we do not guarantee anonymity. The referee will know the set S that sends messages. We can also consider require anonymity, but in this case, we need the channels to be anonymous. And the last point that we consider two models of security, we consider information forensic security, IT security, and computation security. Okay, so what are our results? We construct a few ad hoc PSM protocols. Especially, we show that every function has an information forensic ad hoc PSM. Not necessarily efficient, but it exists. All the functions that are known to have an efficient information forensic PSM protocol, also we show that these functions also have an efficient information forensic ad hoc PSM protocols. And we show that all polytime functions computed in polynomial time have an efficient computation ad hoc PSM, assuming one-way function. So again, these are functions that are known to have a computational PSM using Yau-Garbled circuit, so they will have also an efficient computational ad hoc PSM. We also show a connection of ad hoc PSM with other primitives. We show that we can construct order revealing encryption for two messages with information forensic security from an information forensic ad hoc PSM protocol. We show the connection between ad hoc PSM and a non-interactive MPC introduced in a previous paper. These are PSM that are TU bust, are secure even if the referee can collude with T parties. So we show that NI MPC exists even only if best possible ad hoc PSM exists. We show that best possible computation ad hoc exists if and only if IO exists. And we show that the connection between ad hoc PSM or simple function to point function obfuscation and the fuzzy point function obfuscation. So these are results. What I want to give now examples of two ad hoc PSM protocols. The first one is a very simple one for the difference where k is equal to. The referee should learn xi minus xj mod p, and the common randomness is the random element in zp. And the protocol, every party, each one of the two parties simply send its xi plus the random element. And the referee takes mi minus mj, and the r is canceled, so he gets xi minus xj. So this is the correctness. The security, what the referee gets is simply two elements whose the difference is the output of the function. So this view of the referee can be simulated from the output of the function. So this is a very simple example. Now a more complicated one, ad hoc PSM for the sum. Before I present the ad hoc PSM for the sum, I want to recall the PSM for the sum. So again, we have n parties, each one has an element in Zp, and the referee should learn the sum of the xi mod p. So the randomness are n random elements in Zp whose sum is zero, and each party computes a message xi plus ri mod p and sends it to the referee. The referee simply sums the messages that he got, which is, let's go back. Which is simply the sum of the xi's plus the ri's, which are canceled, so this is the correctness. And for the security, it simply gets n random elements, so sum is the output of the function. So this is the PSM for sum, and we want to use the ideas of this PSM to use the ad hoc PSM, where only a set of size k will show up. And if we'll trivially try to generalize it, we'll have that the sum of every k of the k elements should be zero. So we will have to have all the ri's being zero, and we cannot use it. So we cannot use the idea simply, and we have to use another trick. So we'll construct the ad hoc PSM for the sum of k. The referee should get the sum of xi for the set x which is not known in advance. So for the randomness, we first generate n random elements whose sum is zero as in the ad hoc PSM. And in addition, we share each j using a k out of n secret sharing scheme, and we generate n shares. And PI receives RI, and the IF share of every RJ. So it gets one element and n minus one shares. And the message that PI sends is the same message as before, XI plus RI, and all the shares that it got. What is the output of the referee for set S of size K? For every I in S, it knows XI plus RI. For every J not in S, it got K shares of RJ, so it can reconstruct RJ. The referee sums all this information. And again, the RIs cancel themselves, and we have that sigma. So we get the sum of XI only of the set S. As for the security, note that for every I in S, PI doesn't send the share of RI. So for each such I, the referee gets only K minus one shares in the K out of N secret sharing scheme. So RI is hidden from the referee, and the view of the referee is exactly the view of the referee in the protocol, in the PSM for sum, where for the input of each PJ not in S is zero. So the security follows from the security of the PSM. Okay, let's move more details into our results. So we said we have a construction of ad hoc PSM. So the starting point of this work was a trivial ad hoc PSM, simply execute the PSM for every set of size k. So this will give overhead of n choose k compared to the standard PSM. The advantage of this ad hoc PSM is that it achieves best possible security, and it shows that all functions have an inefficient ad hoc PSM. The disadvantage is it's highly inefficient. So we want to, our goal was to design a more efficient protocol. So for every symmetric function f, we show that there exists an ad hoc PSM protocol with overhead, which is exponential in k, but logarithmic in n, compared to the standard PSM for f. So notice, for k equals 2, the overhead of this protocol is log n compared to n in the simple, in the trivial protocol. And for bigger values of k, the improvement is much more dramatic. For instance, this protocol will be efficient when k is the order of log n. So this is the first construction. The second construction is a reconstructed construction of the ad hoc PSM for f from a PSM for related function g. And by the properties of the function g, we achieve two corollaries. All functions known to have an efficient information theoretic PSM, basically the functions that have some kind type of branching program, they also have an efficient information theoretic ad hoc PSM. And since all function g have a computation PSM, so this implies that all polytime functions have an efficient computation ad hoc PSM, again, assuming random functions. So these are constructions. The last construction is similar to the construction of the ad hoc PSM for the sum function. As the application, we get order revealing encryption. So an order revealing encryption is the private key encryption scheme encrypted with a comparison procedure who gets encryption two encryptions of two messages, and it returns one if and only if x1 is smaller or equal to x2. And the encryption should not leak any additional information except for the order between the inputs. So we show that IT ad hoc PSM implies order revealing encryption, and we use an ad hoc PSM for the greater than function with n equals 2 to the lambda parties and k equals 2. where lambda is a security parameter, we know that the greater than function has an efficient PSM whose complexity is polynomial in L, when L is the length of the strings compared. So using our construction, it has an ad hoc information theoretic ad hoc PSM with complexity log n times poly L, where n is exponential 2 to the lambda, it will be lambda to the poly L. So we strongly use the fact that our protocol is logarithmic in the number of parties. And using this construction, we achieve a statistical information theoretic secure order revealing encryption for two messages. And the complexity is the complexity of the ad hoc PSM, which is lambda times poly L. And for more than two messages, we can generalize the construction, but the leakage would be 1 over polynomial and not negligible. So this is the ad hoc PSM from order of revealing. Let's talk about the best possible ad hoc PSM. In the previous work with Ariel Gabinson, we showed that multi-input function encryption implies a distribution design, and it, in turn it implies a computational best possible ad hoc PSM. We showed that best possible ad hoc PSM implies NIMPC, and which was shown to imply IO, which was shown to imply multi-input function encryption. So this shows that best possible ad hoc PSM exists if and only if IO exists. For this result, we need an ad hoc PSM for relatively complicated functions. And with the question is, can we construct ad hoc PSM protocol for simple functions? So we show that best possible computation ad hoc PSM for the AND function implies point function obfuscation, and best possible computation ad hoc PSM for the threshold function implies a fuzzy point function obfuscation. This primitive is known only to exist under the assumption that IO exists. So conclusion that best possible ad hoc PSM requires stronger assumption with our current knowledge. So let's summarize. We present construction of ad hoc PSM. Every function has an ad hoc PSM. All functions known to have an efficient IT PSM protocol has an efficient IT ad hoc PSM, and all polytime functions have an efficient computation ad hoc PSM, assuming PSM. And we show connections of ad hoc PSM to order revealing encryption, non-interactive multiparty computation, IO, point of function obfuscation, and the obvious open problems. More protocols, improved complexity and parameters, more connection with other primitives, especially for the best possible security. A specific question is how do, even if we want a protocol that for k equals 2, that is secure even if three parties will show up, this is open, and if we'll have some constructions that we'll have an order revealing encryption that is secure even for three messages. So these are the results. Thank you.